Jason and Victor are in the bedroom.
I would like to embrace Becki into the fold. I think, to be honest, you know, she's quite a genuine girl, actually.
Mm-hmm. Also, what did Dan say? Dan was saying something today. He said he doesn't like overly nice people.
And see, Dan's nice to everybody. Dan's overly nice to everyone.
He goes, they've always got an agenda.
I mean, I would maybe, I give Becki a chance, man. To be honest.
Why don't you sound her out then? Then again, like.
No. I ain't gonna go anywhere.
It's just too, like, she's just too smiley sometimes. Just don't know how to read her, man.
For so now, though, Peachy, for now.
I don't like people I can't read properly. Everybody else here, you know who doesn't like who and who likes who better than who, all apart from Becki. It's just, it's in my bones to be paranoid, like. It's in my DNA.
Although maybe my hunch about Becki, I should go with my first instincts, maybe, eh?
I always do, man. She's had enough time to prepare herself to come in, to be nice to everybody.
She's a smashing girl. She's got a little agenda to make her stay last a bit longer.
God's sake, even Dan says she did today.
Which is fair enough, isn't it? She'll keep an eye on her closely.
Most of the housemates are in the living room. Jason's in the bedroom. Armand and Becki are in the garden talking about relationships.
We can all love anybody. You know, stick me in with you on a desert island and I can guarantee within a year I'll fall in love with you. Yeah? If there's nothing else, you fall in love with that thing, but you have to make the right choice.
I know, but it's happened, I'm saying. The best thing is,
all the time. I agree with that, yes. I just speak for me that I don't want to make that wrong choice. I've made those wrong choices and I've learnt from them.
Did you try to upgrade your partners?
Upgrade my partners?
Like clothing and other things.
Oh, I always do that. It's a woman thing. Because we've got better eyes. See, guys get, they get stagnant in a way. Women, maybe it's the way we see things. We've been driven to having to represent ourselves through our faces, you know, through our makeup, through our dress, to attract your attentions. We're the peacocks, if you like.
Mm-hmm. I think that for the majority of men, once they like a woman, whether she wears a makeup or not, it's irrelevant to them.
Well, it's like a man would like a girl in that short skirt. He thinks she's sexy, he wants her. The minute he's got her, he wants to take her out that short skirt and put something long.
But you know that a lot of women are better with long dresses and long skirts than short ones. So I personally, I prefer a woman with a long dress, one color. Red is the best for a woman, okay?
Hold on, excuse me.
Or white. Did you hear it before that?
I don't want to talk to you anymore.
Bye then.
You don't know anything about dressing.
Bye.
Long dress?
Bye.
What are you talking about? Long
See,
dress.
Long
Everyone
dress.
Everyone in your world is going to be long dress and red.
Bloody. You see, you don't accept from men anything.
No.
Yeah.
Apart from money. You got any money to give?
No.
No, forget it. I'm going to talk
to you. No, but anyway, it started there. They say,
do you
want to
bend
buy
over?
Drink.
Have you ever been whipped, Ahmed?
No.
You might like it. Try it. I know you don't like your eyes closed, but try it.
I will do it for you, okay?
But you might not know how to do it. Oh, yeah, Ahmed.
Because you have to decide. I'm not, but I prefer to be more sadic than masochist.
Let me get a bat or something. You'd
masochist.
Like it. I bet you'd like it.
Yeah.
I'll bet you. Not with that, but
I like also biting.
Yeah. I might get up in the middle of the night thinking I'll have it, because I'm so hungry now. I might get up
I like biting, not to be bited.
No, forget it.
Always the upper hand.